I mean, one thing that I'm wondering about, in my area where I live in Louisiana, towards the western end of our state, there's what some people suspect is a Bigfoot type creature. Are you able to look at where I live exactly and see if, to your knowledge, there is in fact a Bigfoot type creature similar to where I live?
With a certain level of certainty, yes, more likely than not. Numerous individuals, yes.
Okay.
But it's not like they're in your backyard, but depends on in your area.
Yeah,
Your state.
maybe a couple hundred or so kilometers to the west of where I live.
Possible.
Okay.
Well, those beings also move about. And
Right.
very often, the government is not intending to let them move about too far and wide. Also, there's the idea of their entrances and cavern systems, etc., where some of those 12 souls, unlikely you're going to find them roaming through your streets.
Right.
A couple weeks ago, I was watching a documentary about a man who lives not too far from me who, he was out in the woods hunting and he ran into a Bigfoot. And he said, before he saw the Bigfoot, everything got really quiet, dead silent. I know, I talked to you about that before. You said basically, the person goes into the fourth dimension, but do you know why people, why do people go into the fourth dimension whenever they encounter Bigfoots? What causes them to go into this dimension?
Oversimplification. Well, correct to go in their dimension, however, the idea being your dimensionality is very malleable, right? So it's not so much they go into a dimension when they see them, it's more they go into another dimension, then they're more capable of seeing things that they would normally not perceive, including what you have called a Bigfoot or a Yeti, right?
Okay.
They're more simply able to, the same way you see, for example, spaceships, right? It's not that they suddenly appear or you suddenly enter another dimension when you see them. You're simply in another dimension, therefore you're seeing more than you would normally see. You will also realize the whole world around you is moving slower, everything seems more vivid, etc., right? And then you're simply more able to perceive things you would normally not even notice.
But I mean, what causes people to go into the fourth dimension? This individual, the man who encountered the Bigfoot, I mean, what caused him to go into the fourth dimension? Why did everything get really quiet for him?
Well, getting really, we can't comment on the direct particular individual experience of this one person, as we are aware who and what this is. However, in general, individuals that enter a fourth dimension or any other dimensional shift always have some inner work done, right?
Okay.
Some integration happened inside of them at a certain moment. They came to an epiphany, energetically or intellectually or physically. They simply achieved a certain moment of breakthrough.
So is that why it's kind of rare for people to encounter Bigfoots? The Bigfoots only exist in the fourth dimension, and it's only once in a great while that, people are walking through the woods and they happen to have some kind of internal, something happen inside them that very rarely allows them to see Bigfoots.
Again, yes.
Okay.
However, the idea also being there's much more to be seen and such. Obviously, there are also people that are just making up stories, etc., that hearsay, right? And obviously, those earlier on, especially those that saw those, that then served as a role model for us, right?
Okay.
Might have also seen something similar. And again, it's mostly a mythological reference point to entities that are dwelling there, which can be different things, but since they are so direct description of Yeti or Bigfoot, etc., many entities also again get lumped in the same category simply because your current population has no other words for them.
Okay. Yeah, and so
Same
like
as your trolls or fairies.
okay. So I'm like right around the time that I had seen this documentary about this guy encountering a Bigfoot near where I live. I was watching the documentary about the Steve Irwin person that I keep talking about, and he basically whenever he was young, he kind of pioneered the idea of like how to best, you know, capture crocodiles and like the best methods to do it. And it's not like he was the first person to ever capture a crocodile, but like he really pioneered like the like how to do it safely and easily and in a way that didn't harm the crocodiles. And so like you might be able to guess like how I fused these two ideas together. You know, like I was thinking like, hey, maybe I could be the first person to devise some kind of trap to capture a Yeti or a Bigfoot. But anyway, like, I mean, would that even be possible? Like, wouldn't I need to, would I have to be able to somehow cause myself to be able to go into the fourth dimension at will in order to capture a Bigfoot?
Once, yes. But once you are in the state where you're able to enter that state, it's unlike you would then come into a contact with an entity that you're coming at with such an intention.
What do you mean exactly?
Your intention would like to be nullified once you're entered that state.
Okay. But I mean, like, what about, you know, like I talked to you before about how there was this group in the Soviet Union called the Snowman Commission that captured a living Yeti, and you said, like, they probably used a net to capture it. So, I mean, like, how did they capture it? Did they have to go into the fourth dimension?
They likely also entered such an altered state, yes. Also, remember, there was also a lot of, well, secrecy by the military at the time, right?
Okay.
They also likely tempered with certain forces, also with their idea of entering another dimensional technological means. You remember your CERN reactor that's also working on such an opening of a wormhole. It's, well, those are, of course, also terms from the science side, but yes, something like that. So, like, they also superseded things with technology, as we have also done, or as we are doing in many instances. Or...
Okay. I was going to ask you if you guys would be willing to, like, give me, like, to help me capture a Bigfoot, like, give me the GPS coordinates or whatever of, like, where their nests are. But, I mean, I guess that would be impossible anyway, right? Like, do they exist at all in the third dimension?
Well, they could technically cross over as well, but it's unlikely. And a nest, we're aware if they have any nests.
Okay.
He's letting us know that if you want to come into the water now, we can play another game.